Hello everyone, let us now understand Woodward-Fisher rule for determination of lambda max of the simple organic compounds. The presentation has been prepared as per the syllabus by University of Mumbai under the title CBCS syllabus for final year B.Pharm semester 7. Woodward and Fisher, they have postulated certain rules for the determination of lambda max for certain skeleton of compounds. The Woodward-Fisher rules are designed to predict the absorbance of conjugated systems in the UV region of the spectrum based on the connectivity of atoms within the system. It is used for finding absorption maxima position, and the calculated values could be different from the observed values by 5 to 6 units. Now, what is conjugation? Such type of structures where we have adjacent double bonds are called as conjugated dimers. This is the minimum requirement for any organic compound to give absorbance in UV region. Here in this structure also we see two double bonds. So this can also be called as diene system. Di stands for two and ene stands for double bond. So these both the structures are diene systems. But what is the difference between these two structures? In the second structure, the double bonds are not adjacent to each other, and therefore this is not a conjugated diene system. So this conjugated diene system, we can number the carbon on which double bond is present. So we can go on numbering like this, 1, 2, 3 and 4. Such system is called as 1,3-butadiene system. The carbon 1 and carbon 3, they both have double bond on them, and therefore this name 1,3-butadiene system. Remember, this is not IUPAC nomenclature. This is not IUPAC numbering. Okay, we are giving that carbon as number 1 on which double bond is present, and then we proceed further with the numbering. If you see here also I can see two double bonds. So this is also a diene system, and yes, both the double bonds are in conjugation. In this particular structure also there are two double bonds, and both the double bonds are in conjugation. 1, 2, 3, 4, and here also 1, 2, 3, 4. So this is also a conjugated diene system, but how it is different from the earlier structure? Yes, these conjugated dienes are in the form of cycles, are in the form of rings, and these are called as homoannular systems. Now, if you see this third structure, if I remove this double bond from here and if the double bond is placed in the other ring, then what I see? I see that there are, yes, again two double bonds. So this is also again a diene system, and this is a conjugated diene system. Such conjugated diene system where the double bonds are placed in two different rings is called as heteroannular system. Now, before we proceed, we should know some important terms. Each type of diene system has a certain fixed value at which absorption takes place. This constitutes a base value or a parent value. In this method, for certain skeletons of molecules from different classes, a base value is assigned. For example, base value for 1,3-butadiene system is 217 nanometers. Base value for homoannular system is 253 nanometers, and base value for heteroannular system is 214 nanometers. Now, in this particular structure, this is the first carbon, second carbon, third and fourth. So this is my conjugated diene system, and these four carbons and the bonds between these four carbons, this makes my basic skeleton. Here also, when it is not in the form of ring, these four carbons and the bonds between them makes my basic skeleton. Now, does it mean lambda max of the following structures are 217 nanometers and 253 nanometers? No. 217 nanometer and 253 nanometers are the base values for these structures, not the lambda max. Then how do we calculate lambda max values? The lambda max will increase based on the attachments on the carbon atoms of the system. So this system could be 1,3-butadiene, homoannular or heteroannular. Only the substituents attached directly to the double bond can influence UV absorption of the molecules. If the substituents are not directly attached to the carbons of the system, it will not affect the UV visible absorption spectrum of the molecule. Now, this structure is little different because there is third double bond which I can see. So if you see more than two double bonds in conjugation with the diene system, see this third double bond in this particular structure is in conjugation with these four bonds, in conjugation with the basic system, right? And this is called as extended conjugation. Now these carbons will become part of the conjugated system. Means which carbons? These carbons will become parts of the conjugated system. You can see all the six carbons are now colored, and all the bonds between these six carbons are now colored. Means what? Means the basic skeleton, basic system has now extended till carbon number 6 because of extended conjugation. Each extended conjugation contributes in the lambda max by 30 units. So now for calculating lambda max, I have added 30 units in the base value. This base value we have taken for the homoannular system. Now look for the attachments on each carbon of the system. So now my system is from carbon number 1 to carbon number 6. I have to see attachments on each of these six carbons. So carbon number 1 has this bond, carbon number 2 has nothing, carbon number 3 has nothing else. On carbon number 4, this is bond present. On carbon number 5, this is the bond. And on carbon number 6, this is the bond. Right? These bonds, which are in green, are on the carbons of the system, and these are part of the ring. Hence, these bonds are called as ring residues. Each ring residue contributes in lambda max by 5 units. And since there are 4 ring residues, there is increment by 20 units. Thus, our calculation reaches till this point, that is 253 for base value, 30 units for extended conjugation, and 20 units for 4 ring residues. Now, in case such bonds on the carbons of the diene or triene system are not part of the ring, then those are called as alkyl substitutions. See, now in this structure, on the right hand side there is no ring. On carbon number 6 and carbon number 4, whatever attachments are there, that is not a part of ring. That is just a single attachment, alkyl attachment. These are called as alkyl substituents. Each alkyl substituent increases the absorption by 5 units. Next term is exocyclic double bond. It's a double bond where one of the participating carbon atom is a part of a ring, while the other carbon atom is not part of the same ring. Word endo stands for double bond which is within the ring. Now in this particular structure, there are two rings, ring A and ring B. This double bond, which is between carbon number 5 and 6, if you see, the carbon number 5 is a part of ring A, but carbon number 6 is not part of ring A. Therefore, this double bond is exocyclic to ring A. Similarly, the double bond between carbon number 3 and 4, carbon number 4 is part of ring B, but carbon number 3 is not part of ring B. Therefore, this double bond is exocyclic to ring B. On the other hand, okay, each exocyclic bond increases lambda max by 5 units. Now, on the other hand, if you see double bond between carbon number 1 and 2, this double bond, the carbons which are participating in formation of this double bond, both of them are part of ring A. Therefore, we call this double bond as endocyclic bond. And these endocyclic bonds, they do not contribute much in the lambda max, and we had already considered them, their contribution has been considered in the base value. Now, since each exocyclic bond increases lambda max by 5 units, there are 2 exocyclic double bonds, so 10 units will increase, and our calculation has reached up to 253 for base value, 30 for exocyclic bond, 20 for 4 ring residues, and 10 units for 2 exocyclic double bonds. And the total of all these values becomes 313 nanometers. Now, you can solve this example by considering base value of heteroannular system as 214 nanometers. In that case, addition of 39 units will be needed for the presence of homoannular unit. You can see here, this 214 we have taken as a base value for heteroannular system. So now this heteroannular system means the carbon, the double bond between 3rd and 4th and between 5th and 6th carbon, that is the basic skeleton we are considering. Then only we can call it as heteroannular system. So 214 units we have added as a base value for heteroannular system. Then I see 3rd double bond between 1st and 2nd carbon, so that is the extended conjugation. Because of the presence of 3rd double bond between carbon number 1 and 2, I can see 2 double bonds coming inside one ring. So that forms a homoannular unit. And we have to add 39 units for such homoannular units. Rest, this 20 is for the 4 ring residues, and these 10 units are for the 2 exocyclic double bonds present. And ultimately, our answer remains the same, that is 313 nanometers. So whenever you have to choose between homoannular and heteroannular, if the molecule contains both homoannular system and heteroannular system, in such a molecule, homoannular system is preferred for calculating lambda max. Now, this is just a figure which I have taken from internet only. So, just to give you the idea that as the number of conjugation increases, more the conjugation within the system, the higher the wavelength of light it can absorb. Thank you for patient listening. More compounds will be shown in the next video for calculation of their lambda max. Thank you.